Hey gang, once in a while we receive an interesting piece of equipment, and this certainly is up there in terms of interest and collectability. The Marantz 8B, the venerable Marantz 8B from the 60s, about mid-60s, and a fierce competitor to the Macintosh 240 and the Harman Kardon Citation. Again, this 8B comes from mid-60s, even though it was manufactured from the early 60s through the 70s, I believe. We've got two units that just arrived at the shop, and we went through them carefully to ensure that they're in tip-top shape and made a few adjustments along the way. So a little bit about the 8B. It's a stereo tube amplifier using a pair of EL34 pento tubes per channel. Producing about 35 watts, and it does. We've certainly had this on the bench and gotten every bit of 35 watts out of this amplifier. It's very, very well built. It weighs in about 56 pounds, which is pretty amazing for a pretty compact amplifier. It retailed for about $285 back in the 60s, which was a good amount of money. And since the collectability is super high on these, they're quite expensive nowadays. There aren't that many left. A lot of them have a lot of chassis rust, or because they're heavy and hard to handle, a lot were dropped and dented and dinged. This is a survivor, what we call a survivor, in really nice shape, and so it's its brother amplifier. Again, we've got two of these in the shop right now. The only differentiator between the two amplifiers is the type of tubes. This particular one, the one with our serial number ending in 216, that's our internal serial number, not Marantz serial number, uses a set of matched, EL34s, original probably, or from that period. These are made in Holland. And then for the 6CJ7s, and in other words, for the face inverters and for the preamp stage, they've got some GE tubes. Pretty cool, nice complement. The other amplifier, ending in 215, has a set of West German labeled tubes. Can't tell the brand on them, but they're also pretty close and match, and a really nice strong set. So these both will be available for purchase on our website. And again, the only differentiators are the types of tubes. Someone might actually choose to use these as monoblocks, in which case they're actually been modified, and it's really the only modification you'll find on these amplifier. They've been modified with an internal switch that lets you parallel the outputs to get twice the power using the 16 ohm taps. It's a very simple modification. It's just a switch with a couple of wires tapped into the terminals. We decided to keep it in place because there is a good likelihood that the same owner will actually want both of these and use them in as monoblocks or dual amplifiers. If you're a purist and you want that switch removed, we'd be happy to take care of that for you prior to leaving the shop. So this amp's been running for probably a good 20 minutes. Tubes are nice and hot and stabilized, and as we go through the bias settings, you can see that we've gone through the trouble of biasing and balancing it. There are several, unlike most amplifiers where you just set the bias on the tubes, this one actually has an AC balance adjustment that we went through very carefully, utilizing a dummy load and a voltmeter, doing some measurements along the way. So we first did the AC balance. There are separate adjustments for that, and then we actually bias the tubes, and it's working wonderfully. A close inspection inside also shows that someone has maintained this amplifier. There's quite a bit of parts that have been replaced to get to be super reliable and as quiet as possible. So some of the signal path capacitors and some of the older resistors were in fact replaced. So this is what I consider a fully serviced unit. Probably ready to operate for another 30 years. Let's take a look. I'm gonna unplug it now. On the back, it's pretty simple. Two sets of inputs, that's really the only unusual things. The second set of inputs, the test inputs are actually unfiltered, while the preamp inputs have a 20 hertz rumble filter built into them to keep your speakers from getting damaged. On the speaker side, you'll see common 4, 8, and 16 ohm taps. Very common for this type of amplifier. Slow blow 2.5 amp fuse and a captive power cord. This one has a plug where there's usually a tube socket. I believe some of these amplifiers had a tube socket in here so that you could power another piece of equipment. But this one looks like it has a factory plug in its place, which is kind of nice because that tube socket is pretty useless nowadays. The paint quality is super good. I would say probably an 8 out of 10. Tiny little scuffs in the corners, but nothing, really no rust. It's got a nice golden copper sort of corrugated finish. The writing is complete and intact. The meter works super well. The glass is clean. The knobs are clean. Very, very presentable unit. One last view as I spin it around. The other thing to note is we don't have the tube cages. I guess these did in fact sell with the tube cage. I've never come across a set of cages. They usually get crushed or rusted. But it's real pretty without it. So as long as you don't have babies or cats running around your listening room, it should be good to go. That's it. Marantz 8B. Thanks for watching.